Hi students, welcome to the next session. In this session, we are going to see the shifting and scaling in discrete. So far we have discussed separately how to do shifting and separately how to do the scaling. Now we can do the combinedly that. For example, this is the given sampling. I am taking the same sample in all the sessions. So suppose if you want to do get x of 3n plus 4. So now how to do this type of thing? So same procedure we can follow that, as you know that in starting case n lies between 0 to 5. So your 3n plus 4 should lies between 0 to 5. So minus 4 less than or equals to 3n less than or equals to 5 minus 4, which is 1. I can write directly. So next step, minus 4 by 3 less than or equals to n less than or equals to 1 by 3. So we know that we have to take only even numbers. So we'll get minus 1 and 0. That's it, I think. So minus 1 and 0 are the only where you can get the output. That means now see, at n equal to minus 1, x of 3 into minus 1 plus 4 will be taken as x of minus 3 plus 1, x of 1, the value is taken as 5. And at n equal to 0, it is x of 3 into 0 plus 4, which is x of 4, which is taken as 2. So now we can write this as at n equals to minus 1, the value is equals to x of 1, which is equals to 5. And at n equal to 0, you are getting value equal to x of 4, which is equals to 2. So this is how your signal will look after sampling and shifting. Sorry, after scaling and shifting. So the same thing, suppose you are having x of n by 3 minus 4, if you want to get this thing. So here we did decimation, here we'll get interpolation, and this is like left shifting, this will be like right shifting. That's the difference. So 0 less than or equals to n by 3 minus 4 less than or equals to 5. So 4 less than or equals to n by 3 less than or equals to 5 plus 4, which is 9. So 12 less than or equals to n less than or equals to 18. So 27, I think it is. So between n equals to 12 to 27, your sample exists. So I think it will be very tedious to do this this thing. So let's take another sample for this thing. Take x of n as like this. Lies between 0, 1, 2 only. That is 3, 2, and 1, like this you just take. So just change this thing. That means your n by 3 should lies between 0 to 2. Because I took this is the new sample I'm taking. So which will change this to like this. 12 less than or equals to n less than or equals to 18. So previously you're having 3 samples. Now it will be, it is increased. That is called interpolation. So when n is equals to 12, substitute here x of n by 3, 12 by 3 minus 4. 4 minus 4, which is equals to x of 0 equals to 3. And for, again, you should take the multiple of 3 only. Why? Because it has to be divided by 3. Take 15. X of 15 by 3 minus 4, which is equals to 15 by 3 means 5 minus 4 x of 1, which is equals to 2. N equals to 18, x of 18 by 3 6 minus 4 x of 2, which is equals to 1. So this is how your spectrum will look like. So it should lies between 12 to 18. Suppose I am taking here 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. This is the thing. So at 12, you are having the value of x of 0, which is 3. And at 13 and 14, you are having 0 value. And at 5, you are 15, you are having the value of x of 1, which is 2. And again at 16 and 17, you are having 0. Again at 18, you are having x of 2 value, which is 1. So this is how you can do the shifting and scaling at a time in a discrete time domain.